Hello one and all, and welcome to PMT's coverage of the Winter NAMM Show 2021. Unfortunately not from sunny Anaheim, California, but from the comfort of our own homes. This global pandemic hasn't stopped some of our favourite brands bringing out brand new guitars, gadgets and gizmos, and today I'm joined by the handsome Sam from PMTV UK, and we're going to have a gander at some new guitars from Jackson. How's it going, mate? I hope you're excited to talk about some of these crackers guitars.
I am, yes. I'll be honest with you, I'm coming into this with a bit of an open mind. As you well know, these kind of guitars aren't necessarily my cup of tea, but I've seen some really cool looking finishes here, and I'm hoping that I'm going to learn a few things from you about these, because these are definitely up your street, aren't they?
I love these kind of guitars, and that's why I kind of wanted to talk to you about them as well, because some Jacksons aren't for everyone. Some people find them a bit too pointy, but I think they're fantastic. And if you open your mind, you will love them as well. The first thing though is probably more akin to you than what you'd expect. This is a new MJ series, which I'll talk about more shortly, made in Japan, Misha Mansur signature guitar. Now Misha is the guitar player in Periphery and is known for his more sculpted, pointy, double cut Strat style Jacksons. So to see this SoCal, more traditional Strat look is quite peculiar for Mr. Misha Mansur. It looks beautiful though. What's your thoughts on it?
No, definitely. I mean, it looks like a Strat. It's got a lovely kind of, what's that? It's a kind of surfy blue finish, matching headstock, really liking that. Normal tremolo. So, not having to worry about the floating trem. I like that.
It's a cool thing. It's rare for Misha, but I'm guessing he wants a more traditional guitar to jam on because he's playing on a few more tracks with other artists now away from Periphery, so I'm guessing he wants a nice versatile guitar. I mean, it looks nice and surfy, but it has got a bare knuckle Ragnarok humbucker in the bridge, which is one of the most intense humbuckers that bare knuckle make.
I was going to say, I'm assuming these aren't these aren't vintage Strat pickups in here. So as you say, yeah, we got a bare knuckle at the bridge. Bare knuckle at the bridge. What are the other two?
The Trilogy Suites, which are kind of Yngwie Malmsteen inspired. So high output single coils. It looks beautiful though. Basswood body, as you'd expect, the SoCal body, Strat body, Strat headstock, locking tuners, go to a 510 tremolo. So you can hammer the trem a little bit and it'll stay lovely in tune with those locking tuners. Caramelized maple neck with graphite reinforcements. It's a nice modern Stratocaster for Mr. Misha Mansur. It's a great thing. Moving down the lineup, we see the Pro Series guitar from Christian Andreu, who, this guitar looks like it suits you, Sam. It's a very nice, natural top. It's very much up your street. What's your thoughts?
I can see myself playing a nice bit of jazz on that.
It's a great thing. I mean, Christian is the guitar player in the band Gojira, which are a French metal band, fantastic band, but they're extremely artistic. And the way they do their guitars, Joe Duplantier with his Charvels and now Christian Andreu with his Jackson V, it's that traditional pointy metal V, but with a lovely classic natural finish on the headstock as well as the body, flame maple top. It's a beautiful guitar.
And just a single, again, I'm assuming quite a high gain humbucker at the bridge.
Yep, Jackson pickup. It's a Pro Series, so it's not going to be a crazy custom shop expensive signature guitar. It's the same one that Christian uses live. Poplar body, flame maple top, through maple neck, one pickup, one volume. All you need to play Gojira on, really. Moving down to something more typically Jackson, this Explorer-shaped Kelly guitar. This is from Brandon Ellis, who's the guitar player in the Black Dahlia Murders. Not super familiar with them, but again, it's just the single pickup. It's a Seymour Duncan parallel axis with one volume and a Floyd Rose. Kind of all you need to get your shred on, really, isn't it? And that classic crackle finish. Again, these are Pro Series guitars, so they're not crazy expensive custom shops. Which, this one looks like a custom shop. This is a smashed glass Marty Friedman signature MF1. Now, it's the single cut Monarch shape that Jackson are famous for. With passive EMG Marty Friedman pickups in. Marty Friedman, obviously, his own fantastic solo stuff and his stuff with Megadeth. But it's a purple cracked glass finish guitar with abalone binding. Personally, Sam, I really want this guitar.
Is that purple or is that pink? That looks quite a fluorescent pink. And I could definitely see that that hanging up on your wall behind you there.
Well, it's an awesome guitar. Mahogany body, cracked mirror top, mahogany set neck, so that classic kind of single cut marriage there of a mahogany set neck and a mahogany body, ebony board with block inlays, 12-inch radius board. It's a classic Marty Friedman single cut guitar, but now in a crackle finish. It's awesome.
Can I just ask on those? The those kind of finishes, is that an actual cracked finish? Those lines aren't drawn on or anything like that?
No, it's a proper cracked finish. Kind of harken back to the 80s Kiss thing, really, with Paul Stanley and his cracked mirror guitars. Kramer had a couple of mirror guitars as well, but those were actual mirrors, and people used to cut their arms on them because they were pieces of cracked glass. These days, though, people have realized that you can get mirrored acrylic and smash acrylic and then stick it to the guitar. So it's a plastic mirror top. Still has exactly the same effect. You just won't cut your forearm to shreds on it, but you'll look awesome.
Health and safety nowadays, eh, mate?
Health and safety. And if there's one thing I know about Marty Friedman, it's his undying love for health and safety. Moving down the way, we hit the Pro Series with the new Misha Mansour guitars. Now, these are the shapes you'd associate usually with Misha Mansour. We looked at his more rounded, traditional Strat shape earlier. These are the double cut designs, a bit more aggressive double cuts that you'd usually associate with the man. Cool guitar though, isn't it?
It is, yeah. And as you say, being a Pro Series, this is going to be a kind of more affordable signature model than the Misha Mansour that we looked at a little moment ago.
It is indeed, but that doesn't mean you don't get the quality and some of the cool specs that Misha is known for, like the Evertune bridge, which means you can set your guitar, essentially lock your guitar in tune, and that guitar isn't going out of tune with itself at all. It's kind of, it looks a bit like a tremolo, but it's not. It just kind of locks your guitar in a certain tuning. Basswood body, caramelized maple neck with graphite reinforcements, but Jackson Misha Mansour signature pickups, as opposed to the bare knuckles that you'll find in his more expensive variants, but you still get everything quintessentially Misha Mansour. And as you see, 6-string and a 7-string just down below. Misha's a huge car fan, and I think he's just sold his Porsche, actually, if Instagram's anything to go by. And this 7-string is in Gulf Blue. So the old Porsche livery, the Gulf Orange and Blue, this new 7-string Pro Series is in the Gulf Blue, which is a cool little feature.
It is, it's a nice looking finish, that is.
Same specs though, basswood body, got the Evertune, everything you expect from Misha, but as Sam said, just a little bit cheaper.
So that kind of looks like it for the new signature model guitars from Jackson. But do you mind if we just go back to something you mentioned earlier on about these Made in Japan MJ series? I mean, as I say, I'm not an expert on Jackson's, but that's something like reasonably new, I'm assuming.
It is indeed. I mean, say new, but it's not exactly new. The MJ one that Sam's referring to was the Misha Mansour one, the blue one, the new Strat shape one. But the MJ range is the new Made in Japan guitars from Jackson, which aren't necessarily new. Back in the early 90s, import guitars were huge, and Jackson had a massive range of import guitars. These guitars were fantastic and now very sought after. ESP and Kramer were importing guitars and naming them as ESP and Kramer in America and the rest of the world. Jackson were doing the same, and these guitars are really sought after, and now they've brought them back, actually made under the Jackson banner in Japan. And the first one we see here is the MJ Series Dinky DKRA, which features an ash top, which is remarkable. Mahogany body, ash top with a beautiful black ash finish. It's crazy
really
looking,
like
isn't
that.
It?
Really like that finish.
White binding as well, setting it off beautifully. Seymour Duncan pickups, it's got a Goto double locking trim, a big old Jackson reverse headstock. It's everything about the early 90s, late 80s, which I enjoy. And there's a few there's a few variants. That's the ash one. There's the DKRP with a poplar top underneath, transparent blue burst, same specs. Actually, no, it's not the same specs. That has Duncan's. The Poplar top has has Damasio pickups. Super Distortion and a PAF Pro. That's funky. I wasn't expecting that.
So that's going to be kind of higher gain.
Somewhat. You can obviously do a lot more with these guitars. Is there, it's a five-way position switch, so you can get the single coil tones from the Damasios and the Duncan's. So they are nicely versatile guitars, and it's a jazz in the neck of the Ash one. So that's a beautiful thing. Moving down the way, there's the more traditional, the guitars that were around in the early 90s, like the simple black mahogany Dinky. There's a beautiful ice blue variant in Alder with the shark inlay on the 12th fret. Also comes in a black and yellow. Can you see that sound? That one looks cool.
Yeah, that's quite striking, that is, with the yellow pickups.
Mm-hmm. And you get the traditional Randy Rhoads guitars as well, with the string through V bridge, Seymour Duncan pickups, Alder body, 25.5-inch scale, but all these guitars are made in Japan to the same amazing quality standard as those ones from the early 90s, those iconic ones. So all those really expensive ones you're looking at on Reverb right now, sack them off and pre-order these from PMC because they're gonna fly off the shelves. So those are the funky made in Japan ones, which are making a resurgence for 2021. Moving down the way to the Dinkies, get the modern Evertunes with a satin graphite finish, the classic kind of almost Misha Mansour look, but in a Pro Series with Fishman Fluence pickups. Also paired with a 7-string in Eureka Mist, which is a fan fret guitar. You ever played a fan fret guitar before, Sam?
I haven't spent too much time with one. Excuse my ignorance then. Why do I want a fan fret? I assume it's something to do with scale length.
Yeah, I mean, fan fret is just the umbrella term for multi-scale length guitars, which does what it says on the tin. The bottom of the fan, essentially, is a regular scale length guitar, 25.5-inch scale. Up to the topper end, where it fans out and the string itself is longer, is a longer scale, down to 27. And that keeps the tension on the lower strings. So this is perfect for people that want to downtune their guitar. Even to drop C or even drop D, if you want a nice high tension guitar, nothing's going to get too flabby. Everything's going to be kept nice and nice and secure. So that's the main thing for downtuning, for fan fret guitars.
Yeah, I'm assuming it takes a little bit while to get used to it, but it completely makes sense, the reasoning behind it.
Yeah, I'm surprised it took so long to catch on, really, but now even brands like Jackson are doing it, and this thing looks fantastic. Basswood body, three-piece bolt-on maple and wengi neck with graphite reinforcements. Great thing, and like I say, in that Eureka Mist finish. Down the way to the Pro Series, these are just some new colours in the Pro Series. The King V, the massive King Vs, and snow white ebony board with the matching headstock. You've got the classic tuxedo Les Paul custom gold hardware look in the Monarch single cut. Poplar finish on the Monarch as well. Mahogany body with a pearl top, with a poplar burl arch top.
That's a pretty one.
It's cool, isn't it? Yeah, I love the good transparent purple burst that Jackson do, especially with the poplar. It looks stunning. Down the way to more of your favourite guitars, the big Randy Rhodes Vs. I know you've got a lot of time for Randy Rhodes.
I do, yeah, as a player, yeah. I just always worry about hurting someone with one of these guitars.
Well, these ones look even more evil with the lightning crackle finishes in white and blue, or there's the black and red. Seymour Duncan JB Jazz pickups again. Now we get down to the soloists, which are quite cool because we're back at the mirror thing. This is the first time you see a Pro Series, which again aren't the most expensive Jacksons in the world, but with some essentially custom shop finishes. So like the Marty Friedman, this has a mirror finish, but it's just a standard cracked mirror finish. Is it cracked? No, it's just a mirror finish. This is cool.
It does look, it's very kind of Silver Surfer, that, isn't it?
It is indeed. It is indeed. Floyd Rose, Seymour Duncan pickups, everything you'd expect, but you can see yourself in it. It's great.
I'll tell you what, to be technical for a second, you're going to have fun filming that one.
It's a lot of fun. Well, I've already got a mirror guitar on the channel, so if you want to watch some fun or want to see some behind the scenes from PMTV UK's videos, watch the videos where I play my mirror guitar, because you can just see the stuff in the background. It's great fun. also, there's a soloist with an ash top, which is beautiful just under that, if you can see that. Mahogany body ash top with what looks like binding around the ash. That's a cool guitar.
Yeah, it's kind of like a little translucent-y kind of snowy finish. Yeah, I like that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, a bit more contoured with that. You obviously can't go very contoured with the mirror finish. They both feature neck through bodies as well, maple bodies. Very cool.
Cool.
And finally landing on this beautiful quilted maple top, purple and gold hardware number. It's a fantastic looking guitar. New colour for Jackson on the soloist. There's obviously 7 strings, 6 strings, hardtail variants, Floyd Rose variants. Too much to talk about in the Pro Series in this video. So if you want more information, get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk for more info and specs that I've definitely missed. But moving down, Sam, to the X Series. The X Series is, as you know, the most affordable range of guitars from Jackson. And there's some awesome new colours in these guys. I'll pick out a few of my favourites, and you can do the same if you like.
Yeah, I'm looking at here. I've got the X Series Dinky DK3 XR HSS. That green is a unique looking guitar.
It's a unique thing. They're kind of going for the Racer X 80s vibe. Cobalt blue with the pink pickups. You've got the neon green with the pink pickups and a very reserved black with the white pickups. I guess there's moving down, there's neon yellow in the Kellys. There's a smashed mirror again on an X Series guitar, which is madness.
Oh, crazy. And again, that's an actual kind of shattered mirror. It's not just a kind of cosmetic vinyl or anything like that.
No, it's actually a smashed mirror. So it's got the maple, the through maple neck on this with the mahogany body and the mahogany wings. So it's a proper good Jackson guitar. Jackson high output pickups, Floyd Rose special. But it's a custom shop look for less money. Down the way as well, there's some camouflage Randy Rhodes guitars that hopefully we'll see soon in black camo and woodland camo. And the last one I want to talk about is the X-Series Soloist in the multicolor camo, because this is very Dokken, very 80s. It's got the winter camo with the greys, blacks and whites, but I don't know why you'd buy it in that when you can get a black, red and yellow camo guitar. Very cool.
Now, where do you have to go to be camouflaged with that guitar?
The sun.
Is that what it is?
The sun, yeah, that's why it was, yeah. George Lynch from Dokken often frequented the sun, and that's where he got the idea from. It's great thing. But yes, like I said before, there are hundreds of beautiful new finishes from the fine folk at Jackson, so check out pmtonline.co.uk to look at the rest of them. Now, let's talk about basses. Are you game for that, Sam?
I'm up for that. I've actually just scrolled down from the guitar we were looking at a moment ago, and I've got the X-Series concert bass. Now, this looks very different from a lot of kind of Jackson guitars and things. I mean, Jackson haven't been making basses for an awful long time, have they?
Not really, not to the extent that they do now. There was Kelly basses back in the day that you'd see with Def Leppard and stuff, but never a traditional kind of modern versatile bass. And with that, there are some new finishes in those basses, but this is a brand new model.
Yeah, they seem to have really expanded their range. I mean, I'm getting kind of, obviously there's, kind of Fender P-Bassy vibes, but also Rickenbacker.
It's definitely Rickenbacker, definitely. But it looks like they've put the thumb guard in the right place, because on Rickenbackers it can be quite awkward to play a Rickenbacker sometimes because of the thumb guard. Yeah, Jackson have kind of went, let's fix this. That's cool.
Definitely. So let's just blast off the specs quickly of this one. So it's a 34-inch scale bass, poplar body with through body maple neck and graphite reinforcement. It's a 12 to 16-inch compound radius board. So that's a kind of modern feature on a classic-looking bass. Active electronics, and it's got a J-style bridge pickup. Oh, so there's a bridge pickup underneath that pick guard, and a P-bass style neck pickup.
That is very cool. And again, with that, it's a through maple neck, which is the same as a Rickenbacker. Now, the look of Rickenbackers can deter some folk, so this bass is great if you want the kind of tone of a Rickenbacker kind of vibe, but don't want the full look of a Rickenbacker, if that kind of makes sense. I think this is a great bass to go for.
Yeah, and that's available in classic colours. So we've got the black and the white, rocket red, and what's the other one called? Absinthe Frost.
Nice. Very cool. So that seems to be the only totally new bass from Jackson for 2021. As I keep saying, there's a myriad of fantastic colours. So check out the new colours on the Spectra basses, 5-strings, 4-strings. There's poplar tops, there's ash tops. Get to Jackson's website or pmtonline.co.uk to check that out. And I was going to end the video right there, Sam, but I've just spotted some new guitars down the bottom again. Some JS guitars.
This is a long list of guitars, isn't it?
It is. Jackson have hit the ground running in 2021. It's mostly like everyone had a pretty crappy 2020. Let's make everyone smile with 482 new guitars in 2021.
So what is this then we're looking at here?
This is the new Archtop JS Series Dinky. Now, the JS Series, like I said before, the X Series is kind of mid-range. The JS Series is where the Jackson range starts. And they've kind of always been very plain, either black or white. Every now and then they might throw in a red one. But I can see right now this 7-string JS has an Archtop, quilt maple top, poplar body, 26.5-inch scale. A proper 7-string for not a lot of money. In transparent black as well.
That's a nice finish, that is.
It's a beautiful thing. Jackson high output 7-string pickups as well, but more fun than that. Yeah, I'm going to stick with that grammar. Why not? Moving down, we'll see the 6-string, which actually has a caramelized maple neck on a JS series guitar. So that is not a lot of money for, again, something. There's a theme here. It's kind of custom shop specs and looks on guitars for not a lot of money. And on this one, as you can see, it's the same specs as the GSs of past. Mahogany body with an arch top. It's got the new caramelized maple neck. Jackson pickups available in black, satin, and red stain. If the caramelized maple neck isn't for you, they continue it down with a quilted maple top. Maple neck with graphite reinforcements again in transparent black burst, green burst, and purple burst. So you can see that quilted maple top. Fantastic things. And finally ending on a JS Series Randy Rhodes in natural finish, with the Jackson double locking tremolo and gold hardware. That's a lot of guitars. And this is a lot of guitar for the money, but this has been a lot of Jackson guitars. And we've just scratched the surface, haven't we?
Yes, so we've definitely checked out quite a lot of guitars today. And I'll be honest, coming into this, as I mentioned at the top of the video, Jackson's not necessarily my cup of tea. I'm not a huge fan of the really pointy guitars, but I've been surprised actually by a couple of these. There's some really kind of tasteful finishes, and some kind of classic inspired designs. Yeah, there's been a few of those that have jumped out at me. I'll look forward to having a little play. So just to kind of recap, the big things that we've taken from this, we've got some brand new signature models, which weren't released before. Loads and loads of new finishes across pretty much all the lines and the bases. Mm-hmm. And the Made in Japan series, that's going to be a pretty big thing for Jackson, isn't it?
Yeah, without a shadow of a doubt, it was a fantastic range back then, and it's going to be more amazing now in all the fantastic colours in which they come in, because as we've just found out, Jackson do fantastic colours very, very well.
So that's all the new guitars from Jackson. As Dagan mentioned earlier, they are going to be available for pre-order on the PMT website. That's pmtonline.co.uk. As usual, don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram so you can keep up to date with all the new products that are coming out at our virtual NAMM show. We're going to be seeing you back soon for another video, very similar actually, where we're going to be looking at Charvel guitars. But until then, I've been Sam.
And I'm Dagan. We'll catch you later.
Nice one. See you soon.